sabahsın dayım.
Yes.
Where are we?
I have no idea. We are in Karaköy now. No, this is the European side, of course, of Istanbul. That's how it is called in Turkey as well. You know, Avrupa and, you know, European coast and the Asian coast. So it's this side of Bosphorus.
Two personalities, two identities.
Well, certainly. I mean, even people living on the Asian side, they will say, you know, I live on the Asian side, and the European side is, I will never live in the Asian side. It's really like, you
as
know,
we
it can
say
be
that going to Istanbul is to go across the gate for the Eastern world.
Yes. I mean, here is a gate to the East for those who live on the West, those coming from the West, and it's the gate to the West for people coming from the East.
Right.
So it's really like the cross. It's a bridge.
It's a bridge, yeah.
Between East and West, and this is particularly true. Even
but in fact, my impression, I don't know if it's just a superficial impression of a tourist, but it's that I came to a place where there is integration, where things are seen both ways from different profiles.
For Istanbul, I would say definitely yes. I mean, this is a place where you can find, first of all, people coming from all other cities in Anatolia, all over Turkey. They are coming to Istanbul. First of all, there's the integration of those cultures as well, because they have
inside Turkey.
It's an internal migration from other cities, because it attracts. It's like a
which
magnet.
Which is not an easy thing. I mean, at least from Italy, we can consider that it's not an easy
it's
thing.
It's not an easy thing. It's easy.
We experience
exactly
the discrimination between South and North. No?
Yes, here I think it's easy as long as you have economic growth, of course. I mean, when there's the industry who needs labor and the laborers are coming all over the place, they can't find a job. So economically, as they become integrated economically, they become integrated socially as well. I think that's that way around.
That's a very interesting point you're raising. Economic wealth may improve social relationship and even human rights.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, if you live in the suburbs of Istanbul, on the outskirts of Istanbul, if you don't have money, sometimes you don't come here. You don't see the sea sometimes. It's possible to live in Istanbul and not to see the Bosphorus. There are people like that because they don't have money.
So it impinges even the freedom of movement.
Exactly. If you need money to move, you need money to go to a movie, you need money to be able to have breakfast in a cafe.
And
or
to know what is your own town. Because you are the same. Otherwise, if you don't have money, you don't leave your own town.
Exactly. You don't leave your neighborhood. I mean, you go to your work, you come back. You don't have much income to spend, right, disposable income. You know, after you do your basic needs, you buy your basic needs, you can just sit home and watch TV. And that's how you can integrate, by watching TV maybe, but that's all. So it's true that when you have an economic boom, when the city's economic output is increasing,
Turkey is doing very well.
For the last 10 years it went very well. Except for 2009, the year of the crisis, it's going very, very well, much higher than anybody else in the region. So it's absolutely.
Now you are seen in the positive side of
yes,
the
national. Yes, we will still be. I mean, this year is the soft landing year, what they call it, if you want. After high growth rates, we are landing softly to a more, you know, a lesser growth rate, but still it will be 3% growth. So yes,
which is
there is economic growth still, and people can find jobs. So when they find jobs, they can integrate also to the city. That's for sure. So there's this side, and also there's the other side, that, you know, also the way of life here. You know, the Turkish elite or Turkish businessmen, business people, they have a European way of life. Most of them. So you can find here bars, restaurants, discotheques, or what have you.
You know, during last February, mm-hmm. we came here organizing a talking on leadership at the International Media Festival here in Istanbul. Yeah. And what struck me was that 99% of the participants were women.
Really?
Women interested in leadership.
Well, that's very good to hear.
How do you comment that?
Well,
is it a surprise also for you?
It's surprise for me because 99%. It's amazing because generally when I
say 99%, I mean that just a single person was a man.
It was really 99%.
Even more.
No, that's very interesting. I mean, it's a few things. Personally, I believe if you don't. There is no equality between men and women in a country, it cannot be developed. Okay? That's my view. Secondly, for Turkey in particular, we have 30% of women participating in the labor force. This is unacceptable. Unless it goes over 50%, at least we have no way we can go further. We can close the gap between the West and our country. That's very important because our aim in any country is to become a developed country like South Korea did successfully.
Right.
South Korea, Turkey, they were at the same level in the 70s. Then South Korea did very clever policies, okay? And they picked up the right industries to support export, etc., etc. They have become now one of the developed countries of the world and they closed the gap almost 100% with
developed countries. They are highly competitive.
Exactly. Now, if Turkey wants to do the same, and of course it wants to do the same, naturally that's what you aspire to when you live in a country, when you lead a country, okay, there is no way we can do that without integrating women in the workforce, in the labor, in economics, okay? So that's not only surprising that 99% of participants were women, because as I told you before another occasion, you know that 14% of the parliament now is women, which is considered a success because before there was never 14%. So you see the problem. I mean, there's a problem of women participation in every facet of the social life in Turkey and economy.
But the trend is improving.
Definitely. And secondly, when you meet with women, business women in Turkey, they are much more impressive than the businessmen on average. I mean, that's my experience. Why? Because to come to the same level, they have to work twice harder.
Right.
I certainly believe so. It's true.
Yeah.
You know, so there is...
Do you think that Turkish women or women in general, because probably we can generalize worldwide, are more interested in occupying a leading role in the society and the business environment, or rather... Mm-hmm. They are trying to show a different model of leadership, in a way a leadership which is more sensitive to social aspects, to the environment, to human relations.
I think it's...
Which could be also the reason for the success.
Yeah, I think in their nature, I think woman has a different way of leading.
Right.
That. Which I find they are more sensitive. They see better, I think, what the others feel. They are more sensitive on these issues that men generally are not.
They are also more teamwork oriented.
I think absolutely you are absolutely right. I mean, they are
more individualistic.
Exactly. Yeah, right. And women are not. Women are more, you know, I think they are more better team workers. Maybe sometimes that is what keeping them becoming a leader, maybe. I don't think so, but it can be. But I think you are absolutely right that they have a different way of seeing things and doing things. And I think it's not a question of better or different is better. Because then you have a choice.
You have a choice.
Because then you have different things. And different is always good. I mean, homogeneous, all companies are the same, will never work.
As we said during integration. I mean, integration...
Exactly.
Emphasize the differences.
Exactly. It's good to have differences. Yeah. You know, on the basics, you will, like ruling a country, you will have a constitution that will set the ground rules, but then you have to leave free people. And within this constitution, within this framework, right, people are free to do what they want.